We covered most of the complicated and confusing areas of Scala functions. In this video, I want to cover three simple but important techniques: variable length argument, default values, and named arguments. Let's start with the first one. Most of the programming languages support the notion of variable length arguments. Scala is not an exception. It allows you to indicate that the last argument of a function is a variable length argument. So, it may be repeated multiple times. Here is an example. You can use it like this. You can pass as many arguments as you want. You just need to remember few important observations. The repeating argument must be the last argument, right? So, this one is invalid. The next observation is obvious. All of these values are of same data type, right? If the variable argument is of type integer, you can pass n number of integers, but you cannot mix in a string with them, right? Inside the body, S is an array. When the type of S is a string, inside the body, S is an array of strings. When the type of S is an integer, inside the body, S would be an array of integers. That's it. Let's move to the next item. Default values and named arguments. Let me start with the named arguments. I will show you an example and explain Scala syntax for the same. So, here is my example. It takes two parameters, a function and a string. I can use it like this. The first parameter is a function value and second one is a string. By default, you will always pass the parameter in the order specified at the time of function definition. If I try changing the order, I will get an error. The named argument allows us to pass the input parameter in a different order. Let's try it. The name of the string parameter is S. I gave this name at the time of function definition. What is the name of the function parameter? F, right? The example worked. I can call the function even after changing the order of parameters. But the named argument doesn't make much sense without a default value. I mean, why would I want to change the order of the parameter? There must be some reason, right? It doesn't make any sense doing something without reason. However, it starts making sense as soon as you give a default value for an argument. Let's start with the same example. You can assign a default value for a parameter using an equal to symbol. Let me give a default value for the first parameter. If the caller doesn't pass any value for the first parameter, Scala will take the default value. That's it. Now, if I want to skip the first parameter and supply only the second parameter, I get an error. Not enough arguments, right? There comes the named argument. Use a named argument and you can skip the first parameter because it has a default value. The moral of the story is this: to make some parameters optional, use the default value to define them and then use the named arguments to call them. Simple as that. That's it. Check out my GitHub account for the Scala notebook. You will get some simple questions to practice the idea. Thank you for watching Learning Journal. Keep learning and keep growing.